Hello everyone, welcome to science class. I hope you all are doing well. So we have finished chapter 4, heat and temperature. Now it's time to summarize the chapter. Let's take an example. Take a sip of hot water and a cold drink. Do you feel any difference? Yes. So whenever heat flows out of our body, we feel cold. And whenever heat goes into our body, we feel hot. So when we drink a cold drink, what happens? This cold drink takes away heat from our body, that is why we feel cold. On the other hand, when we take hot drink, heat flows into our body, that is why we feel hot. Thus, heat gives sensation of hotness or coldness. Heat is a form of energy which has the ability to do work. For example, engines move a car by converting heat energy into mechanical energy. Heat energy can also be converted into other forms of energy, like a firecracker. It converts into both sound and light energy. So when there is a difference in temperature of two bodies, heat flows from one body to another body, which we call it as heat energy. Heat can be, the unit of heat is joule. So one calorie is equal to 4.2 joule. Now there are some general effects of heat. What are these effects we are going to discuss now? One is heat brings about change in temperature. So when we supply heat to a solid, liquid or gaseous substance, its temperature increases. Similarly, if a hot material gives out heat energy, its temperature falls. Second is heat can bring changes in dimensions also. So we can discuss about
expansion
of solids, liquids and gases. Expansion in solids, all solids we know that they have definite shape and definite volume. Their particles are closely packed. So when heat is allowed or heat is supplied, they
expand.
And they expand in all dimensions like linear, superficial and cubical. Now expansion in liquids, liquid particle they are loosely packed. They have space in them. So liquids, they
expand
cubically. Now we have
expansion
in gases. Gases have no definite shape, but they have definite volume. So when gases are heated, they show cubical expansion. Expansion in gases takes place more than solids and liquids. Now third is heat brings about change in state also. So by using heat, we can change the state of a matter also. For example, water. So ice can be converted into liquid water, which is by heating we can convert this. Then liquid can be converted again into gaseous state by heating. So these are some examples of effects of heat in our life. Now heat can be transformed into various substances through some methods. These three methods are conduction, convection, radiation. Conduction is a method by which heat can be transferred in solids. Here, what happens? Heat can be transferred from one body to another body. Then we have convection method. As you know that water is a poor conductor of heat and electricity. So how can we supply heat there? So through convection method, we can supply heat in solids and liquids. Now radiation. Radiation, it is a process to transfer heat energy from a hot body to a cold body. For example, heat reaches us from the sun. So this is all about heat and temperature. I hope you have understood this chapter well. I will see you all in the next class. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.